Hello friends, this is Roshni. In the previous video, we have learned how to include a label with the text and label with the image in the GUI window of Python using Kindle package. So in this video, we are going to learn how to include a label and a button with the event handling in the GUI window of Python using Kindle package. So the output of this program will be looking like this. Here we will have a label and here we have a button. So when I click on the button click me, hi will be changed to hello. And once again when I click on the button, hello will be changed to hi. This is what we are going to learn in this video. So let's start coding from the beginning. So first we have to include the module Kindle, and we have to import everything from this module Kindle. Then we have to create a class. Let us name the class as label button, which is going to inherit a frame class, which is a predefined class. This frame class helps us to give all the basic functionality of a window, including the command buttons such as minimize, maximize, and close button. Then we have to include the constructor for this class using init function. Inside this, we have to call the constructor of the parent. So the parent is frame class, then we have to call its constructor using the init function. Then we have to set the title of the window. So to set the title of the window, first we have to say self, which means the current instance of the class, that is the label button, which is the window. And then we have to say master, which is the parent of the class, that the frame. Then we have to say the title. The title of the window should be specified here. So let us give the title as label and button. Now the title of this window is ready. Then we will check the output of this. So to run this program, we want to call this constructor. To call the constructor, we have to create an object of the class. So whenever we create an object of the class, automatically the constructor will be called. Next, we have to call the function main loop. This is very important because main loop will help us to display the window infinitely until we close the window. So now if we run this program, we could able to see the window with the title, label and button. If we want to change the size of the window, we could also do like this, self.master.geometry. Then here inside we have to say the length, width and the length, height of this window, width and the height of the window. So now if we run this, we could able to see a bigger window size because we have set the window width and height. So at present let us not going to use this. The next thing is we are going to specify the layout of this window. So now we are going to use the grid layout, which is mostly used and more efficient. And now we are not going to say in it rows and columns. So if it doesn't specify the row and column, automatically each and every comment will be added in the next rows. So we will create a label now. So in the current window, so self dot, let us name the label as label one, and we are going to assign the label object to this variable. So the label class, and we have to pass the argument. The first argument is self, the instance of the current class, which is our present window. Then we have to say the text for the label. So we will say the text of the label is hi. Next, we can able to change the background color and the foreground color of the label. So let us change the background color of this as any color we can specify. Even you can say it is blue. Then we can change the foreground color. So FG equal to, we can give the color as white. So now the label box is ready. So now if you run the program, we could enable to see the label, since we have not attached the label to the window. To do this, we have to say self.label1, that is the name of the label object, dot, we have to say grid. So now here inside the grid, we are not passing which row and which column, so it will be automatically placed in the first row of the window. So now if we run this code, we could able to see a label with the green color, blue color as the background and the white color as the foreground. If you want to change the width and height of this label, we could able to do by self.label.config. And here inside we have to say the width and the height. So let us say the width as 20 and let us specify the height as some 3 and the width as 10. It could be good. So now if we run it, we could able to see a bigger label with the height as 3 and the width is 10. So now the label box is ready. The next thing we want is we want a button. So create a button, same thing. First we have to specify the current object, the current window self dot. Then we have to say a name to the button. Let us name it as but1 equal to, again we have to assign the button object to this variable. So the button class, and to this we have to pass the argument. Always the first argument is self, the current object of the class, the current object self. So it specifies the label button. The next thing is we can also specify what is the text to be displayed on the button. So here we can say click me. The next thing is we can also change the background color of this. Let us give some hexadecimal values like A, B, B, and some value we can give. Then we could also change the foreground color, and let us give the foreground color as white. So now the button is ready. The next thing is we have to place this button on the window. To place the button on the window, we have to say self dot. The name of the button we have given is but1 dot. We have to say the layout of it. So grid. And here again, we are not going to say the row and the column. So it will be placed in the next row in the window. So now here we can able to see the button click me and the label on it. So the next thing is here again, if you want to change the width and height of this button, we could able to change by self dot. Name of the button is but1 dot config, and here we can say the width as we can say as 20, and we can able to say the height as some 3 or 2, whatever it may be. So now if we run it, we can able to see the button and the label over it. So here what is, now we are going to add an event. What is an event? Any change if you make on this is an event. Here the event we are going to do is click event. So when I click on this button, the text on the label should change. That is our objective. So we have to change, we have to include an attribute called command. And this is the attribute to attach the event to this button. And to this command, we have to specify a function. So we are going to write a function, that is user defined function. We will name the function as change. So just specify the name of the function. We are going to define this function. So command is an attribute helping us to add event handling to this button. Now the button is ready. The next thing is we have to define this function change. So this is the class and this is the constructor. So inside this, we are going to define the next function, that is change. So this change is defined here and it is inside the class. So now inside this function, we have to write the code, how to change the text from hi to hello on one button click and hello to hi on the next button click. So let us define this function. So inside the function, I'm going to say if because we have to now take the data or the text from the label. So how to take the label? Here it is. So we have to say self.label, and the attribute of that is text. That is what we have to change. So if the text is equal to hi, then we have to change this self.text to hello. So we'll say it is hello. Else, we have to change this to hi. So that is what a small event we are going to do. So the command is calling a function called change. The change function is attached to this button as an event handler. Then inside the change, we have set the self dot. In the current class, we have a variable called label1 and its attribute text. If the text is equal to hi, then change that to hello. And if it is hello, we have to change it to hi. So if we run this program, so now when I click the button, hi is changed to hello. Now once again, if I click on the button, hello is changed to hi. So we have done it. Thank you for watching.